Welcome back to another Final Cut Pro tutorial. Today's about adding drop shadows to your text or making it glow. Let's check it out right now. First, we'll navigate to the Titles and Generators menu on the top left. And we'll just drag a basic title into our timeline. Let's move our playhead a bit so it's visible in the viewer. Now we'll navigate to the inspector on the top right. Click on this icon to activate your inspector if it's not already visible. And make sure this text icon is selected to access the text inspector. Let's change the title to something else. And we'll size it up so all the changes we make will be a lot clearer. That's perfect. Now, in the text inspector, scroll all the way down and click on the glow checkbox to activate it. It's kind of hard to see right now, so we'll change the face color of the text to black. Much better. Let's hide these face controls. And down here, we'll click Show to expand the glow controls. It doesn't quite look like a glow yet, so let's tweak these settings a little bit. We can drag this blur control to increase the falloff of the glow. It still doesn't have enough falloff, so let's click and drag this number up to increase it even further. We can also increase the radius to extend the range of the glow. Now that's glow. Balancing the radius and the blur will create the perfect glow effect. Now we can change the color by clicking on this color well. You can choose any color you want from here, but we're going to select red. Click this red X in the top left to close the window. And if we click this drop-down, we can also apply a gradient. But we'll just keep it red. Why does this title feel so familiar? Anyway, let's move on. Before we get to the next step, can we remind you to like, share, subscribe, comment below, please and thank you? We've already prepared this project and just need to add in our drop shadow. Click on the checkbox next to drop shadow and a soft shadow will appear behind the text. To the right, click on Show to expand the controls. Next, scroll all the way down. Let's reveal this shadow a little bit more. We'll increase the distance from the text so you can see it more clearly. We can change the color of the shadow using this color wheel. But for this example, we'll keep it as black. Below that, we can adjust the opacity of the shadow. We can make it more subtle or more visible. We'll keep it around 75. We can also control how much falloff there is on our shadow. We'll keep our falloff fairly low so that we have a hard shadow. Next, as we've shown you, this distance control will simulate a closer or farther distance between the text and the background it's casting a shadow upon. Last but not least, we can use this angle control to imply a different position for the light source in this scene. Some cool effects can be achieved here, like if we change from a color to a gradient. If the gradient controls aren't yet expanded, be sure to click on this triangle. And we'll double-click on the color tag to change the color of one end. We can change the top of the drop shadow to make it look more like a light. When finished, close out the window. If we increase the blurriness, it even starts to look like a reflection. Play around with the glow and drop shadow controls to make your 2D and 3D titles really stand out. Now add a drop shadow or make it glow in Final Cut Pro. Don't forget to check out Pixel Film Studios, where you can find Final Cut Pro plugins designed for beginners and professionals alike to take your projects to the next level. You've now learned a couple of new tricks in Final Cut Pro. Want to learn more? Like, share, subscribe.